إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، أعاذنا الله وإياكم من الضلالات، وهدانا وإياكم إلى سواء السبيل، إنه على كل شيء قدير. We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our master, our lord, our sustainer, our provider, and we testify that there's none worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Rasulullah Muhammad, peace be upon him, is his final messenger. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather us with him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the highest level of Jannah. Allahumma ameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I remind and advise myself and you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As he subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, we who have believed, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way he should be feared, and do not die unless you are in full submission to your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not die unless you are on the state of the Islam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us steadfastness on the path of Islam until the last moment of our life. Allahumma ameen. Less than 30 days to the month of Ramadan. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala firstly to allow us to witness the month of Ramadan. Amen. And we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us and to enable us to worship Him in this month as it should be worshipped. Allahumma ameen. Today is a reminder for myself and for you, and a question that I came to ask myself and you about the how is your preparation for the month of Ramadan. We've talked about it in the last couple of khutab, but it is very important to keep reminding ourselves, my brothers and sisters, because it is really a great chance for everyone subhanAllah to be forgiven, to be freed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's punishment permanently. And therefore we have to remind each other, we have to be concerned about this month and about preparing ourselves, preparing our hearts for the month of Ramadan. So in the month of Ramadan, we are capable of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as it should be worshipped. So in the month of Ramadan, we are capable of abstaining from the haram and pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you will not be able to achieve that unless you have a well-prepared heart. Unless you have a strong heart, a wide heart. We've talked in the last two khutab about some of the tips, some of the advices that we should put in consideration when we walk on the path of preparation. But today, I want to focus with you guys on a very important point, which is a question that may come to you and me. What made us lazy of the ibadah? Why do we feel heaviness when we decide, when we think to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why our hearts feel very, very locked when it's invited to walk on the path of ibadah, on the path of obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why? And the second point that I want to emphasize on, or that I want to mention or remind myself and you of, is how can we overcome this feeling of laziness? How can we overcome this feeling of laziness? With the first point, my brothers and sisters, we need to remember constantly that المعصية the sins and the shortcomings with the minor or major sins. And by the way, the weight of ma'asiyah is up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not up to us. So nobody can say, oh, this is the minor sin and this is the major sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who weights his ma'asi, subhanallah. رُبَّ مَعْصِيَةٍ تُورِثُ فِي الْقَلْبِ ذُلًّا وَانْكِسَارًا خَيْرٌ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ طَاعَةٍ تُورِثُ فِي الْقَلْبِ عِزًّا وَاسْتِكْبَارًا. So it's not about our criteria, it's not about our measurement. The weight of the ma'asiyah and the ta'ah is up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala almighty. Subhanallah. A ma'asiyah can bring you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than a ta'ah. A bad deed, a ma'asiyah, a sin, can bring you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than a good deed, than a ta'ah, than a good act of worship. Why? Because the sin may humiliate and humble yourself. And the ta'ah would make you proud, would put this pride in your heart. And some of us may refer the ta'ah to himself or to themselves. And this is a big sin, a major sin in itself. But anyways, we feel weak because of the status of our heart. And this is something that we want to remember constantly, my brothers and sisters. That you're strong when your heart is strong and connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You feel very weak. You feel lazy when your heart is not as strong as it should be. When your heart is disconnected from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When your heart is detached from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether dunya or ma'asiyah or this person or this and that. So al-ma'asiyah تورث في القلب كما قال ابن عباس ذلا وظلمة. So المعصية leaves darkness and weakness in your heart. Any معصية you do, whether a small معصية in your sight or a big one, whether looking at a haram, mentioning someone badly, backbiting someone, belittling a person, oppressing your spouse, being involved, getting involved in haram, walking to haram, listening to haram, any ma'asiyah you do leaves a darkness and weakness in your heart. And ma'asiyah after ma'asiyah, sin after sin, your heart becomes very vulnerable. Very vulnerable against what? Very vulnerable. Any fitna can affect it. Any fitna, any trial, any test can impact it. Because it's not immune. It's not immune. And this is the point that I want you to remind yourself. إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ وَاللَّهِ It's a very scary statement, subhanAllah. قال ابن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنهما إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لَيُحْرَمَ الرِّزْقَ بِالذَّنْبِ يُصِيبُهُ. So the servant may be prevented goodness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rizq from Allah. And the rizq, it's not only money. Al-hidayah to rizq, guidance is rizq. This moment you spend with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is rizq. The ability that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you to help someone is rizq. Reading the Quran is rizq. Looking at the Quran is rizq. Attending the jama'ah in masjid is rizq. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu said this very interesting statement. He said, إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لَيُحْرَمَ الرِّزْقَ بِالذَّنْبِ يُصِيبُ. So you or I, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يعني, don't make us from them, Allahumma ameen. A person, a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may be prevented goodness for a ma'asiyah, for a sin that he's committing. This risk can be turning away from the Quran. The risk that you may be prevented for your ma'asiyah can be for your heart to be turned away from the Quran. I cannot open the Quran. We talked to the brothers in the last khutbahs and the last reminders, in the previous reminders about the importance of opening the Quran even for one ayah a day. And with that, some brothers and sisters would struggle to open the Quran for one ayah a day. Say for 5 minutes to remember Allah. And yet a lot of brothers and sisters are still struggling to do that. Why? One of the main reasons is for the darknesses in your heart that have been put into it because of the sins and the shortcomings you do. Allah is very important. And it's very scary as well. SubhanAllah. Very scary. And SubhanAllah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all from heedlessness. Allahumma ameen. My brothers and sisters, one of the most scary things about the ma'asiyah and the impact of it in your heart is with time, your heart will go into coma. As the Nabi said, لا يعرف معروفا, you will not be able anymore to recognize goodness or to do it. You cannot do it. Brother, come and do this. Stop the listening to haram. Stop watching the haram. I cannot do it. I cannot. I'm struggling to stop. Because you have the engine that pushes you on this, on the path of, you know, worshiping Allah and on the path of purification. It's in the coma. And some hearts, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all from this type of fast. And some hearts are dead. They live following and obeying their hawa, their desires. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran about these people, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us from them. Allahumma ameen. أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَاهُ. Having you seen those who have taken as their gods their desires? وَأَضَلَّهُ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ وَخَتَمَ عَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِ وَقَلْبِهِ وَجَعَلَ عَلَىٰ بَصَرِهِ غِشَاوَةٍ. This is the heedlessness that we are seeking refuge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from it. That when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seals someone's heart, sight and ease, he cannot listen to goodness, he cannot listen to khayr, he cannot see goodness, he cannot recognize goodness. Sealed. Allahu Akbar. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says by the end of the ayah, فَمَنْ يَهْدِيهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ اللَّهِ. And he can guide this person, he can save this person, he can take this person out of the darknesses that he or she lives in. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, we're saying that, we say that as long as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exists, there is hope. As long as that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exists, there is hope. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran said, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to you, his servants, and starting the ayah, subhanallah al-azim, how great is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. He's starting the ayah by saying, يَا عِبَادِي. Yani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, do not think that by committing ma'asi and dhunub, I will push you away from me, I will disown you. No. Allah is saying to them, يَا عِبَادِي. يَا عِبَادِي what? All my servants that have wronged themselves, that have transgressed against themselves, do not despair of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy, as He forgives all the sins. So there is hope. The second point, what should I do? What should I do? A man came to Rasulullah, and this is the answer. Oh, I'm gonna leave you with one thing to do. And wallahi, by Allah, this is not a promise for myself. It is a promise from Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you're gonna maintain this ibadah, if you're gonna maintain this ibadah, your heart will change. Your life will change. Your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change. A man came to Rasulullah. Said, Ya Rasulullah, إن شرائع الإسلام قد كثرت علي. فقل لي في الإسلام فقل لي قولا لا أسأل عليه أحدا بعدك. عبد الله بن بشر الصحابي كنت رسول الله. سيدي رسول الله, the obligations of Islam became heavy on myself. It's hard. I cannot do it. Or I'm struggling to do it. Ya Rasulullah, give me an advice. What should I do, Rasulullah? صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, هذه السوليوشن هي, لا يزال لسانك رطب بذكر الله. What should I do to get rid of this laziness, to overcome this laziness in my heart? What should I do to purify my heart? What should I do to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? لا يزال لسانك رطب بذكر الله. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, keep your tongue wet with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا إله إلا الله. الذكر will change my heart, yes. الذكر will fix what the ma'asi, what the sins have done in my heart, yes. الذكر will make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes. This is the ذكر. Why, Ya Rasulullah? Why would you say a dhikr? Because my brothers, let me give you an example. Someone would say to you, you want to commit adultery with this lady or this man, that's fine. Go and do that. But after you finish, we're going to throw you into this oven, into this fire. So do whatever you want. But after you finish, we're going to throw you into the fire. Will you do it? You, that's it. I want to do the haram. I want to do the haram. But someone is saying that's fine. Do the haram. But after doing the haram, we're gonna throw you into the fire. Nobody will do it. Why? Because you can see the fire. Because you're scared of the fire. You're scared of the punishment. This is exactly, subhanAllah, what the dhikr does in our hearts. That we remember Allah. When you remember the mercy of Allah, the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the severe punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you remember it properly, when you live seeing it, this is the ihsan that al-dhikr will help you to reach. When you live seeing it, and ta'bud Allah ka'annaka tara'as, worship Allah as if you can see it, as if you can see him, you will abstain from the haram. You will say, إِنِّي أَخَافُ إِنْ عَصَيْتُ رَبِّي عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. I'm scared of the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm scared. And this is what Yusuf sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said when he was enveloped to the haram. What did he say? قَالَ إِنَّهُ رَبِّي أَحْسَنَ مَثْوَيْهِ. He said, definitely I would not disobey the one who honored me, the one who guided me. I would never, ever disobey him. Why? Because he can see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can live with Allah. He can feel the divine presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the thing we'll do. And by the way, you would not find a result immediately. Some brothers will say, oh, that's fine. You see the dhikr? Okay, I'm going to say astaghfirullah, 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 astaghfirullah. I'm still looking at the haram. What's dhikr of Allah? It's to remember Allah in everything you do. It's to remember Allah. Mentioning Allah's name by your tongue will help you to remember Allah. But a dhikr is not only mentioning Allah by your tongue. Mentioning Allah by your tongue is a sabab for you to be connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the dhikr of Allah is to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every movement you take in your life, in every decision you make in your life, in every action you do in your life. You remember Allah. That's it. Remember Allah. And you know what is the importance of that? Even if you commit a ma'asiyah, And by the way, dhikr would not prevent us from ma'asi. Dhikr would not make us infallible, ma'asumeen, no. But the benefits of dhikr is it will connect your heart to Allah. And when you commit a ma'asiyah, you remember Allah. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهِ. This is the one of the main benefits of dhikr. Is it with the ta'ah, you remember Allah and you thank Him. With the ma'asiyah, when you commit a sin, when you commit a shortcoming, تَقْصِير فِي حَقِّ اللَّهِ, you remember Allah as well. And you ask for forgiveness and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives you. I'll leave you with this too. What is the main cause of this laziness and weakness we experience with our heart? Al-ma'asi. So stop committing ma'asi as much as you can. Just stop committing sins. And even when you commit it, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His forgiveness immediately. And the second thing is, dhikr of Allah. And keep your tongue wit with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make it a habit, my brothers and sisters. Fill up your time, your life, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His names. And you will find yourself gradually leaving the music. That's it. The fake happiness that you used to experience with listening to music, for example, or by looking at the heart, will go away. Wallahi, will go away. Why? Because the sweetness of Iman will replace it. Subhanallah. Wa ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us all to His path. Allahumma ameen. Wa ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty to make our heart, our tongues wait always of His dhikr, of His remembrance. Allahumma ameen. And we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty to forgive us shortcomings and sins and to cleanse our heart from the impact of the sins and the ma'asi that we've committed. And we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty to guide our hearts and to allow us to witness the month of Ramadan. قُلُوا قَالِ هَذَا أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي الحمد لله وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, so إن شاء الله after الجمعة we're going to pray the absentee prayer on two of our brothers, one of a brother and a sister that have passed away yesterday. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower them with His mercy. Allah, and actually praying absentee prayers is one of the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Nabi sallallahu prayed on the Najashi. Right? And inshallah praying for these people will benefit them inshallah Rabbil Alameen. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower them with His mercy, and we inshallah encourage you to stay. And the second thing is, we are starting this Monday a very important course, or a very important initiative, which is a Fajr Book Club. Or we're resuming the Fajr Book Club. And Fajr Book Club will be started at 2021, in the beginning of COVID. And basically, after Fajr, every Mondays and Thursdays, we study, we contemplate, we reflect together on books of tazkiyah, books of purification. So it's a good opportunity for everyone, inshallah, to gain this knowledge of how to purify the heart. It's online, on Zoom. It's good to start your day with this positive energy. It's good to start your day with ta'a. It's good to start your day with a gathering of dhikr, blessings for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are starting this Monday, inshallah, a new book called The Purification of the Soul for Imam Ibn Khudam al-Maqdisi. We're going to be talking about the soul and your nafs, how to purify it, how to validate your nafs, how to fix the issues of your nafs, how to understand yourself, your nafs, subhanallah. So it's a very, very important initiative. If you would like to be added, we have a WhatsApp group where we share the Zoom link of the lectures and also some tips and some reminders as well. If you'd like to be added, please message me or message Brother Ahmed or message for the sisters, message Umm Yusuf Sashara, inshallah, and you'll be added to the WhatsApp group. So this is an initiative that I encourage all of you, inshallah, to join. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى في أعيائه وكبريائه أن يتقبل منا إنه هو السميع العليم. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا اجمعين، وهب المسيئين منا للمحسنين، اللهم ارزقنا قبل الموت توبه، وعند الموت شهاده، وبعد الموت جنه ونعيما، واحشرنا مع سيدنا صلى الله عليه وسلم مع الذين انعمت عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين، وحسن اولئك رفيقا. الحمد لله رب العالمين.